Hi guys, welcome to Roll Talk. Today we have with us Mad Men star and scene stealer, Miss Stephanie Drake. Thank you, Stephanie, for being with us.
Oh, really thank appreciate you for it. Having me. It's so nice to be here.
So let me ask you, what was your first professional job that you got paid for? Yeah.
I booked a commercial, mm-hmm. a national commercial. It was my very first job. It was for York Peppermint Patties. Oh. It was maybe like 7-8 years uh-huh. ago. And I was thrilled, except I'm allergic to chocolate.
Oh my gosh.
Which I was a little nervous about.
But you weren't going to turn that job down.
No, I certainly wasn't. So I get there and I was playing an ice princess, so I had to be ice skating. Mm-hmm. I mean, I wasn't really ice skating, but they had me spinning as if I was all afternoon. And they did not tell us ahead of time that this was what I would be doing. Mm-hmm. I've never been so dizzy, oh so sick in my life. I mean, at one point they had a chair screwed to the floor and they wound it up like a top. And I just sat there like staring up at the sky while the camera was like spinning above me, and I'm just spinning in circles, spinning. I got through it. Like, luckily I have a pretty good stomach, so right. I never threw up. But at one point, the medical guy had to give me Dramamine, and I had to go sit outside and look, because you know how they say when you're seasick to sit outside and look at the horizon?
Right.
I just had to sit outside and just stare before I could drive home.
Right, yeah.
I mean, it was that bad. I was so off kilter. I feel like I'm still kind of dizzy from it.
Here's a little tip from a dancer. Spot. Find a spot in the room, but it's probably
that's
too much.
That's what everyone kept yeah. telling me, but it was like 5 hours of spinning. I mean, it wasn't normal. It was crazy. They never aired the commercial.
Oh my gosh.
I know.
Did the check bounce? I hope it was good. No. No, I'm just kidding.
But I got into the union from
that's
that.
Great.
So it was wonderful.
So it worked out.
It was
out.
Worth it.
Right.
Totally it worth it. It. And it was a great experience.
Cool. So have you found the business? How do you find that your craft has evolved in, let's say, the last 3 to 5 years?
I think I just am always trying to try new things. Mm-hmm. Get outside my comfort zone. That's a huge thing. I always tell people, yeah. I will take any class, I will do any kind of activity that gets me outside my comfort zone. Because okay. you do, as an actor, you get comfortable, you get lazy when you're not constantly doing stuff. So, and auditions don't happen every day. So you always have to be doing things. So I've done it all. I've taken writing classes, improv, stand up. I'm in an improv class right now at Groundlings. And I think all of those things help you in the end. You're always meeting new people. You never know what kind of friendships and connections you're going to make, and all of that helps you when you do book that part.
Right.
And when you do go into those audition rooms, they want to see a well-rounded actor, not, you know, there are those days when you're just sitting at home and
right.
nothing to do. There's only so much television you can watch,
right.
you know? So I think that's been the biggest thing in the last few years. I've really tried to just do as much as I can.
So let's talk about Mad Men a little bit. You play Meredith,
mm-hmm.
Breakout star on that show.
Oh,
I mean, your part is
you.
Hilarious, and you have a heart also. So how did you feel? I'm sure you were over the moon, but how did you feel when how did the audition process go and subsequently getting the role?
That was just a regular audition.
Mm-hmm.
I was super excited to have an audition.
Right,
I didn't
right.
have that many at that time. So I went in, and I had never seen the show.
Okay.
So the night before, I watched an episode to prepare. Went in, had the audition. They had me come, like, right then, they were like, can you come back at 4:30 this afternoon for the producer session? So I was like, yes.
Yes.
Call back. Woohoo. But still, just thrilled to be asked back. So I show up for the producer session. There's maybe a dozen of us girls. And I hear a voice from inside the room from the girl in front of me, and I'm like, holy crap, that's Matt Weiner. That's the creator of this show.
Oh, right.
Like, even though I don't watch the show, you know who he
yeah,
is from
right.
the Emmys mm-hmm. and the Golden Globes.
Right.
And I mean, my gosh, he's everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
They'd won so many awards. So I was like, oh my God, oh, he's in there?
Yeah.
So I go in. You'll find this funny. The first thing he asks me is, where are you from? I said, I grew up in Baltimore. He goes, me too.
Oh my gosh.
He's from Baltimore.
Oh my gosh.
I know. So I mean, I really think that has a huge reason how I ended up getting the part.
That's great. That's great. See? So Baltimore, Baltimore works out for us.
It sure does. I'm so happy we moved to Baltimore.
So how's your time on the show? Is it as fun as it seems? Or?
It was wonderful. Yeah. I mean, from that day that I got the call that I was on hold for it, I had no idea what it was going to turn into. Right. I was just happy to be a part of such a landmark show and get to work with these amazing actors. And they just kept calling me back. And calling me back, and then they would go on hiatus, and all summer I'd be like, "Am I gonna get to go back?" And then I'd hear from someone that they started shooting, and I'd be like, "Oh, I haven't heard from them. I'm not going back." And then I'd always get a call, and then by that last season, gosh, I was in so many of them. It was unbelievable. I mean, you hear about things like that happening to people, but. It actually happens.
It happens.
Yeah, it actually happens.
It'll rub off on me. Huh?
No. I wish it would happen for everybody.
Thank you for joining us. This has been Real Talk. If you have a dream in your heart and a plan, it's never too late. Thanks, Stephanie.
Again. Appreciate it.